Good morning, all of you. In today's session, we are going to start with the 10th standard chemistry and physics, unit 12, carbon and its compounds. In the earlier session, we completed what is mean by homologous series and what are the various functional groups present in the carbon and its compounds. In how many ways carbon and its compounds are significant in nature, and what are the allotropic forms of carbon, what's the valency of the carbon, and in what way carbon is available in our nature. All these got completed in the earlier sessions, and what is isomerism possible in the carbon and its related compounds. These are topics were discussed in the earlier sessions. In the series number 13, we are going to start with a systematic nomenclature in order to assign naming for these compounds, because carbon and its compounds are versatile and millions of compounds are available. It is not possible to identify. It is not possible to remember each and every compound individually. That's the reason why they are streamlined. They are sorted out into a certain groups so that a particular guidelines, universal protocols are provided in accordance with the IUPAC, International Union for Pure and Applied Chemistry. And the strategic guidelines were framed in order to give the naming to these compounds so it is possible to name the compound whatever it will be. So even new compound introduced into the laboratory, into the research platform, it is possible to name in accordance with the guidelines which already established here, right? So those topics are discussed in series number 13 of unit 12. In addition to all these, we already completed unit 1 to 11 and all these detailed explanation for 10th standard chemistry and physics available on the channel called World of Competitive Chemistry. Now, let us see series number 13 of unit 12, carbon and its compounds. Here, we are going to start with the nomenclature of organic compounds. Already just now we discussed. So, organic compounds are versatile in nature. It is not possible to count how many compounds are there in organic chemistry. So many compounds are newly introduced per a day, because carbon and its related compounds are most significant in the medicinal industry, agricultural fields, and even in the human body, we are having so many organic compounds. All the living organisms are composed by organic matter, in a primary manner. So that's the reason why it is very important to recognize the compound, name of the compound, so that we can assign the properties, what kind of properties will be there, in what way we can best to utilize these compounds. That's the reason why nomenclature plays a vital role here. Let us see how it can be framed, right? So the basic idea behind the systematic nomenclature is that it should only one name for the given structure. For example, so in our locality, we are keeping one name for the given compound. So if we move to another place in the universe, so if we are moving to another nation, for example, so the name will be changed so that there will be ambiguity between the compound. Though compound is same, but naming is different, we can't identify, we can't locate the compound, what is what. That's the reason why, in order to clarify all these hurdles, so here a systematic nomenclature and the proper protocols and guidelines are provided in order to name the compounds, which are framed by International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, simply named as IUPAC. IUPAC, it is international strategy where the guidelines are given. So according to that, it is very simple to assign the name to the compound if we know what are the fundamental and sequential rules which are given to assign the name to any individual compound. Based on this, it is very simple to identify which compound and what will be the name of that compound, so that here it will be a universally accepted kind of naming system for all these organic compounds. Being organic compounds are in the millions of quantity, that's the reason why it's very essential to frame certain strategy to name them, right? So let us see what will be the naming of these compounds. In accordance with the IUPAC here, to name any organic compound, first we have to classify that name into three major parts. One is root word, second is prefix, third is suffix. Root word is nothing but main word which gives the major meaning of that compound is called a root word. Prefix is nothing but which we are going to incorporate in the first letter or first position of that one. Suffix is nothing but at the end of the compound. So that is called a suffix. Root word is the main proportion. Prefix is the front line coming word. And suffix is the last line coming word. So these three are the important parts in accordance with the IUPAC to assign the naming for the given organic compound. Let us discuss about all these in detail. First is about word root. The number of carbon atoms present in the molecule or the principal chain is called a word root. The major portion, the main skeletal carbon chain. So the principal carbon chain is designated with the word root. Here, for example, the given compound is assigned with only one carbon. You can give its name as a meat. If two carbons are present in the given compound, eth it will be. Three carbons prop, four carbons bute, five carbons pent, six carbons denoted as hex, seven carbons hept, eight carbons if there oct, nine carbons non, 10 carbons dec. So this is a strategy wherever these carbons are present and this naming will be fixed. For example, the given compound having five carbon chain is there, you have to assign it as a hex as a root word. So this is about assigning the root word to the given compound first. So whenever compound is given to us, we have to segregate that compound. How many carbons are there? First of all, we have to count number of carbons present in the compound. Based on its number, it is possible to give its root word. So these are the root words corresponds to C1 to C10. More words also there, but it is the fundamental thing we are going to recognize. And next is about second parameter called a prefix. Prefix is nothing but the word we are going to insert in the front of that root word. The substituents in the molecule are shown by the prefix. So whatever substituents are present, any new group is there as a branch, as a side chain. So that will be inserted as a prefix. So again, this prefix are several parts. A primary prefix will be there, secondary prefix will be there, numerical prefix will be there, number prefix also present here. Right. So here prefix is nothing but the letter or the word which comes in front of the root word is called a prefix. Okay. So here again, prefix can be subclassified into primary, secondary, numerical, number prefix. Four types are there. So what is meant by primary prefix? Primary prefix is nothing but it is used for only cyclic compounds. Whenever cyclic compounds are there, you have to insert the prefix as cyclo. So any ring system, any cyclic system is there. So for example, I'm taking the three membered ring, so made up of three carbons only, because less than three carbons it is not possible to construct the cyclic organic compound. So minimum three carbons are required. That's why I'm taking the compound three carbon one. So when three carbon cyclic compound was taken, being it is three carbons, the root word will become three carbon root word will be prop, right? Then what will be the primary prefix here? For these cyclic compounds, primary prefix will become cyclo because it is in the ring form. Hence, we have to assign cyclo as a primary prefix, cyclopropane, because three carbon, that's why propane will be your name. Cyclopropane, cyclo will become a prefix because it is coming in front of the root word. Right. So this will be a primary prefix. So usually it is applied to the cyclic compounds where you have to assign cyclo in front of the root word. Move on to secondary prefix. Secondary prefix can be assigned to second grade functional groups whenever halogens, ulkyl, ulkoxy, such a kind of functional groups are present. Halo group is there. We have to designate that functional group as halo. When alkyl group is there, that can be indicated as alkyl. Alkoxy. Alkoxy is nothing but alkyl with oxygen. So both are present in adjacent manner. That is denoted as alkoxy. So here few of the examples are mentioned. So, hello all kids, the simplest example was taken here, CH3CH2Cl, where chloro is the substituent. So, this will be a secondary prefix, right? So, whenever chloro, alkyl, alkoxy, these are regarded as a secondary prefix. So, it can be taken over here, chloro. Then what is the root word? How many carbons you can identify? Two carbons are there, so that it will be ethane. Chloroethane will be a complete name in accordance with the IUPAC. And here, chloro will be the secondary prefix. Here, chloroethane is a complete name. Now, move on to another compound, 2-methylpentane, because we have to identify one of the alkyl substitution here. I'm taking the chain of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon chain can be taken. At the second position, we have another methyl group. So that you have to indicate what's the position of this methyl group, where it is located on the second carbon. That's why 2-methyl, because methyl present on the second carbon, 2-methyl. And what will be the root word? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon chain always. Always root word will be 5-carbon pentane. So this will be assigned with the pentane. 2-methylpentane is a complete IUPAC name of the given compound. Haloalkane, halo will be the secondary prefix. Methyl is the secondary prefix. Wherever it is present, that number we have to indicate over here. And in either compound called alkoxy, here alkoxy also mentioned as a secondary prefix. That's why here table of alkoxy compounds are provided to us. We are taking ether compounds. Whenever alkoxy was taken, ether came into picture. So here the common name of the compound will be dimethyl ether, but it is not correct to give the common name in accordance with the IUPAC. So naming will be alkoxyalkane. Alkoxy means how many carbons you have? 1 carbon. So it will become methoxy. And the root word will be 1 carbon. So it will become methane. Methoxy methane. So 1-methoxy methane is IUPAC name of this compound. In this manner, here, whenever halo, methyl, alkoxy groups are present, all these are regarded as a secondary prefix and they will come in front of the root word. Move on to another prefix, another kind of prefix called a numerical prefix. Numerical prefix is nothing but numbers will be indicated. So in order to mention the position of the functional group, it is very essential to indicate the number of that carbon position, right? So here, when the same substitute are present for multiple times. In that case, what we have to do? We have to indicate di, tri, tetra. If 2 groups are present called di, 3 are present called tri, 4 are present called tetra, 5 present called penta. In this manner, we can indicate how many times the number will be repeated, which is called a numerical prefix. For example, this is a compound taken into the observation where chloro groups are present in the first carbon as well as second. So here 1, 2, that indicates the position and how many times it repeated, that is di. Because 2 times, if 2 times repeated, you can say di, 3 times tri, 4 times tetra. So in this manner, it will become di. Dichloroethane, because root word with the 2 carbons, so that we have to assign ethane as a root word, right? So here, the numerical prefix indicates what, how many times the same functional group is repeated. If it is for 2 times di, 3 times per tri, 4 times per tetra, in this manner, we have to indicate numerical prefix. And the next is about number prefix. Number prefix is especially used to assign the position of the functional group. For example, I'm taking a double bond at the first carbon, double bond in between the second and third carbons as well. So both are having same number of carbons. Here also we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are there. Then what will be the stratification between these two? Here, double bond in between first and second. Here it will be in between second and third carbon atoms. This means 1-butene indicates double bond on the first carbon. 2-butene indicates double bond on the second carbon atom. That is nothing but number prefix. This number number designates where the functional group is located. What will be the position of the functional group? 1-butene, 2-butene. So this 1 is the number prefix. Numerical prefix is nothing but how many times the functional group is repeated in the given compound. Di, tri, tetra is a numerical. 1, 2, 3, 4 will be a number prefix, right? So all these are the part of prefixes only. Primary prefix, secondary prefix, number prefix, numerical prefix. These many prefixes are present. So we gone through prefix, and only the leftover term will be a suffix. Suffix is nothing but last word. So if you are indicating your name, first word, middle word, last word will be there in your name, right? In the same manner, your also organic compound have root word, prefix word, suffix word, right? So here suffix is nothing but last name. Okay, so here last name is nothing but the functional group in the molecule are shown as a suffix. Whatever functional groups are present, that functional group is indicated as a suffix. It also contains several parts known as a primary suffix, secondary suffix, numerical suffix, and a number suffix. Just like a prefix, here also you can assign primary suffix, secondary, numerical, and the number suffix. Of the examples are demonstrated here. So if the given compound is alkane, alkane is nothing but all the bonds are single bonds only, and you can say that is the saturated one, where suffix will be for all alkanes the end last word will be compulsory ane. For example, one carbon is there, that will be methane. Two carbons, ethane. Three carbons, propane. So always the suffix will be fulfilled with ane for alkenes, right? So root word depends upon number of carbons, but for all alkenes the suffix will be ane itself, right? So this is only for alkenes. If the given compound is alcohol, nothing but hydroxy compound, hydroxy, OH is the functional group over here. When OH functional group is there, the suffix will be assigned as a ol. Methanol, ethanol, propanol, ol is the suffix for the given compound. End word will be, last word will be ol. Ol will be a last fulfilling word. Alkene. So if we are taking any double bonded compound, double bonded organic compound, the suffix must be ene, because double bond is designated with ene. So if you are taking two carbon chain, so you have to assign as a ethene, three carbon propene, four carbon butene, five carbon pentene. In that manner, whenever alkene is there, the end word will be ene. So that is the suffix or ending word. Aldehyde when present. Aldehyde is nothing but C double bond OH. C double bond OH functional group is called aldehyde. Always it will be terminated with, it will be ended with al. So there is a slight difference between alcohol and aldehyde. Alcohol will be ol, aldehyde will be al. Alcohol will be oh, aldehyde will be double bond oh. There is a slight difference. Don't get confused with this. So if we write methanol, methanal, that will become aldehyde. Methanol, NOL, that will become hydroxy compound. By replacing O with A, hydroxy will become aldehyde. So there is a slight difference between these two, but the compounds are entirely different. So you have to take great care, because both are pronouncing like a same, sounding like same. Methanol, methanol. But here OL will be their hydroxy, AL will be their aldehyde, right? So that is for aldehyde, alkanol. And next is about amine. So when amine is nothing but nitrogen containing functional group, and suffix will be amine. So for example, I'm taking CH3NH2 as a compound. CH3NH2, how many carbons are there? One carbon, so that we have to indicate meth. Then amine is a suffix word, so that it is designated as methanamine, right? one carbon, and it should be ended with, name should be ended with amine only. That's why IUPAC name of the compound will be methanamine. If two carbons are there, ethanamine. Three carbons, propanamine. In that manner, whenever amine is present in the compound, the name will be ended with amine itself. Whenever ether is there, ether is nothing but oxygen functional group. R, O, R when present, that is designated as ether. So, ether suffix word will be alkoxy-alkane should be given. It will be indicated as ether itself. Alkoxy-alkane is the IUPAC name of the compound. Here, oxygen will be indicated as an alkoxy group. Oxygen will be indicated as an alkoxy group. That is the naming for ethers. And when ester was taken, ester is nothing but C double bond. O group when present in the given compound, that is called ester. R, C double bond, O, R is called ester functional group. So here, IUPAC name of the compound will be alkyl-alkanoate. Alkyl-alkanoate is the name. Oate will be your suffix. Oate. So I'm giving simplest example. CH3, C double bond, OCH3, for example. CH3, C double bond, OCH3 I'm taking. In that case, methyl ethanoate is a IUPAC name. Methyl ethanoate, right? Because here two carbons we have, it will become, long chain will become alkanoate. Methyl ethanoate. Right. So whenever ketone is there, ketone is nothing but simply C double bond group. So here this side alkyl is there. C double bond group is present in the central part. In that case, suffix will be on. The suffix is designated as on. Then I'm taking again simplest example, CH3, C double bond OCH3 for example. So we have detailed discussion about all these functional groups, but here it is the simple representation for individual functional groups are provided. CH3, C double bond was CH3, for example. In that case, the name should be ended with ON. So when CH3, C double bond was CH3 is there, number of carbons will become 3. In that case, root word will be prop. And it should be ended with ON, right? That's the reason why IUPAC name of the compound will become propanone. Propanone will 3 carbons, we have double bond O, that will become propanone. Nitrile. Nitrile is nothing but carbon nitrogen triple bonded one. So always the word will ended with -yl. Okay. So it will be ended with the -yl. So this is about cyano group. Cyano in general, that is a common name, but IUPAC name, it will be regarded as a nitrile. C triple bond L, C triple bond N. And if you are taking CH3, C triple bond in ethane nitrile, name will become ethane nitrile, right? So in this manner here, suffix will be a name of the functional group. The functional group will be indicated hydroxy with ol, aldehyde with al, double bond with ene, single bond with ane, triple bond with ine, amine with amine, ether with ether, ester with oate, ketone with ON, triple bonded nitrile with the -yl. So this is about the suffix ending word. And the next is about primary suffix. We will discuss in detail about what is what. Primary suffix is nothing but, this tells about the saturation of the compound, whether the given compound is saturated or unsaturated. Saturated means all bonds are single bonds, then you can say saturated. Unsaturated, either double or triple bond will be there. So when carbon-carbon single bond is there, primary suffix must be ane, right? Here, alkane. In this, ane is there. This indicates methane, ethane, propane, butane. In that manner, always name will be completed by the insertion of ane as a suffix. Next is about unsaturated carbon-carbon double bond. Whenever double-bonded compounds are there, the name of the compound will be completed by the addition of ene, E-N-E. Alkene, in here itself you can assign this ene. Ethene, propene, butene, pentene, hexene. In that manner, For all the double bonded compounds, name will be completed by inserting ene. For triple bonded, ine will be the suffix. Y-N-E-ine. Ine, ethine, propine, butine, pentine, hexine, heptine. This will be our triple bonded compound. And this is about all these primary suffix always used to indicate whether the compound is single bonded, double bonded, or triple bonded. All these are indicated with single bond ane, double bond ene, triple bond ine. This is called a primary suffix. And for secondary suffix, certain functional groups are given here. This tells about the functional groups with the particular term. While writing the name of derivative hydrocarbons, last letter will be E. E must come here. So this is applicable. E is applicable to hydrocarbons. All hydrocarbons are alkanes, alkenes, alkynes. So here you can clearly observe alkane having E, alkene having E, even alkyne also having E over here. So that E must be present for all the hydrocarbons, whether it may be saturated or unsaturated. For hydroxy compound, ol, aldehyde, ale, ketone, one, on, and carboxylic acid, oic acid, ethanoic acid, methanoic acid, propanoic acid. In that manner, oic acid is the suffix. All these comes in the secondary suffix. Particular functional group will be designated with the secondary suffix. So here, for hydrocarbons, the name must be completed by the insertion of E. Alkane, alkene, and alkyne will be there, right? And for hydroxy compound, the EPAC naming will be in the manner methanol, where one carbon is there. Ethanol, OL denotes what? OL denotes hydroxy compound, it will be, right? Eth denotes what? Two carbons chain, it will be, right? CH3, CH2, OH, where ethanol, right? Two carbon chain with the hydroxy and the terminal center. Whenever propanol was taken, CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. Prop denotes the three carbon chain at the terminal center, hydroxy will be there. Propanol, three carbon. Isopropanol is nothing but this hydroxy will be shifted from first to second. So that isopropanol, in all the cases, hydroxy denoted with OL, OL, OL. So this will be for hydroxy compounds. Move on to aldehydes. Aldehyde means CHO group is called aldehyde. When one carbon, methanol, two carbons, ethanol, three carbon chain, propanol, four carbon chain, butanol. So in this manner, as the number of carbons increases, you have to increase the root word. But always for aldehyde, the suffix will be AL. All these are the part of secondary suffix only. And next is about ON. So if we consider ketone, C double bond group is there. In that case, ON is the suffix over here. Then here we have two carbons. One carbon is there. This will be a 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon chain with a second position double bond. So that we have to indicate root word will be but, and ketone is indicated ON. So that butanone is a complete IUPAC name of the compound. For 5 carbon chain, here double bond was present and the third carbon. So that 3 pentanone, 3 denotes what? Where the double bond was there. 3 is the prefix over here. This is called a number prefix, right? So where C double bond group is present, that is denoted with 3. And how many carbons? Root word will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So pent will be a root word. And functional group will be a ketone. Hence, you have to indicate pentanone. And if 5 carbon chain is there, that will become hexanone. And if any side chain is there, methyl present on the second carbon atom, hence it is designated as 2-methyl. And ketone is there on third position, so that here 3-hexanone. 2-methyl, 3-hexanone is IUPAC name for this compound. All these are the part of ketones where ON is the suffix over here. For the compounds of carboxylic acid, oic acid is the suffix. Let us go with first carbon. Only one carbon is there in the compound called formic acid in simple manner. That's a common name, formic acid. But in accordance with the IUPAC, here it is designated as methanoic acid. because oic acid is a suffix. So being it is a one carbon root word will be meth. Methanoic acid is IUPAC name for one carbon. If two carbons are there, ethanoic acid. Simply we can say acetic acid, common name. So here, propanoic acid, where three carbon chain will be there. So here, prop is the root word and the oic acid is the functional group over here. Four carbons butanoic, five carbons pentanoic acid. This is about carboxylic acid, oic acid will be the suffix over here. Now, let us segregate all these terms into a single platform. The following will be the order for naming any organic compound. So numbers must be there in the given name, numerical prefixes if applicable, secondary prefixes if applicable, primary prefix it is only applicable to cycloalkanes, secondary prefix if any functional group is present, numerical prefix how many times the functional group is repeated, what will be the position of that functional group, that will be a number, root word welcome in this place, and numbers welcome, numerical prefixes welcome, and primary suffix is applicable to what? Primary suffix is applicable to carbon-carbon single bond, double bond, and triple bond. So carbon-carbon single bond, double bond, and triple bond will be denoted with the primary suffix and the number suffix. Numerical suffix will be there. Secondary suffix also present for the functional groups. This is about the order for naming of all these compounds. What's the differences between 1, 2, 3? 1, 2, 3 all comes under what? Prefixes. All these are used to indicate either what we can say, cycloalkanes. So one denotes cycloalkane. Two, secondary regulation will be for what? This is for whether the compound is having chlorofunctional group, alkyl functional group, alkoxy functional group. In that case, this second regulation will be applicable. Third regulation will be, what will be the third regulation? That is nothing but numerical values, how many times functional group is repeated. Then 6, 7, 8, and 9, 10, 11. So what will be the difference between all these numbers? So we have a detailed discussion. Let us go with 1 and 2 are numbers, numerical designations to be written the secondary prefixes, which tells you about the position and the repetition of the second grade functional groups known as substituents respectively, right? For example, so if chloro group is there in the chain, so we are taking a three carbon chain is called a prop, because root three carbon will become prop. In this three carbon chain, chloro group either present at first position, second position, right? So here you inserted chloro group on the second position. So then how can we give the name for that compound? So it will become 2-chloropropane. 2 denotes what? At second position, chloro group is present. 2-chloropropane. Prop will be the root word, and being it is a all single bonded, you can say N, and chloro group is present at the second. In that manner, your number is very essential to locate the functional group. So this is the simplest example provided to you. I'm taking the 4 carbon chain over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. When 4 carbon chain was taken, here second and third position, both the positions are having chloro functional groups. Let us give numbering first. 1, 2, 3, 4. So second position chloro, even third position also chloro is there. So here we indicated 2, 3, because second and third both are occupied by chloro. So how many are there? It is repeated for 2 times. If 2 times repeated, you have to denote with the di. 3 times, tri. So in that manner, 2 times di will be indicated. What are the groups? Chloro. That's why dichloro it will be. Then what is the root word? 1, 2, 3, 4, bute. 4 carbons always bute. And all are single bond. That's why ane is the suffix. So this is the number prefix. This is numeral prefix. This is the secondary prefix. Bute is the root word. an is the suffix for this one. So this is about these many fragments are present in the single name. Each and every fragment is having its own significance in order to identify the name of compound. 2,3-dichlorobutane. 2,3-dichlorobutane is the name, IUPAC name of the given compound. Now, let us discuss about 6th and 7th regulations provided by IUPAC. Point 6 and 7 tells about the position and the repetition of the multiple bonds present in the given structure. These are related to primary suffix. That tells about the unsaturation. I'm taking two compounds over here. Whenever triple bond is located in between first and second, double bond is located in between third and fourth, and I'm reversing that sequence in another compound. I inserted double bond in between first and second carbon, and fourth and fifth carbons are indicated with the triple bond. How it can be? How the naming is changed? Here triple bond is there in between first and second. Here triple bond is there in the fourth and fifth. Though we are not changing the position of triple bond, why the numbering got changed? Here the double bond is present between the third and fourth. Here double bond is present between the first and second. That's purely based on least number, greater preference. Least the number, greater the preference. Based on that concept, we have to assign the numbering over here. So here, whenever double bond is present in between first, terminal carbon atoms, the numbering will be obviously started from here, because if compatibility is there, computation is there between double and triple bond, obviously double bond will get the priority over triple bond. That's the reason why we have to assign numbering for this double bonded carbon when compared to triple bonded carbon. But in case of this one, when you start with numbering from the second carbon, it will become 2, but it will become 1. So always list the number, greater the priority. So here functional group is present on the first carbon. Here the functional group is second and present on the second carbon. That's the reason why numbering should be started from the right hand side. But in case of second compound, where the double bond is there on terminal one terminal center, triple bond is there in another terminal center, in that case, we have to go with its priority. Always double bond get priority over triple bond. That's why numbering will be started from this double bonded carbon atom, and numbering will be completely reversed over here. This is about repetition of the functional groups. We have to take the great care while giving the numbering. If numbering is reversed, entire name of the compound will be reversed. So here numbering will be started. 1-2 position is having triple bond. Always triple bond suffix will be ine. Double bond suffix will be ene. And root word will be how many carbon? 5 carbon. So that it will be pent. And while writing, what we have to see? We have to see alphabetical order. Among ene and ine, which will come first? E or Y? E obviously will come first. That's why ene will be written first, latter ine. So this is about the regulations in order to write the name of the compound. So let us repeat one more time. Whenever triple bond, double bonds are present in the given compound, first of all, we have to assign the numbering. So being this carbon is associated with triple bond, obviously will be given with number 1 position. So among 1, 2 positions, we have triple bond, right? That's why 1 will become ine. Triple bond always will become ine. So here in the same way we are moving forward, so that here third carbon is having double bond. When third carbon double bond is there, double bond is always suffix will be ene. So double bond suffix will be ene. Total how many carbons are there? 5. So 5 carbons root word will be pent. 1 carbon meet the 2 carbon, eat the 3 carbon, prop 4 carbon, but 5 carbon pent it will. So in order to write ene and ine, so what we have to write? Ene will come first in accordance with the alphabetical order, right? So that's the reason why pent 3, ene 1, is the right order in order to write the name. Okay, so here it will be, here first carbon ene, fourth carbon ine, root word will be pent. Pent 1, ene 4, ine is a compound 2, where numbering will be indicated in this manner. And 9, 10 tells about the position and repetition of the functional groups. if I'm taking the simplest example, two carbon chain with the chloro functional groups and the same carbon. What is the position of chloro group? One chloro, one chloro. So if chloro is present on two times, so two times is indicated with di, numeral will be di. So 1 comma 1, that is the position. So this will be your number. 1 comma 1 dichloro, then root word will be ethane. 1 comma 1 dichloro, ethane will be the name of the compound. So in this manner, we have to assign the name for the given compound. And next is about, if it comes only once, we need to write, need not to write mono. If any group is present one time only, for example, one of the chloro group is not there, need not to write monochloroethane. Just you have to indicate chloroethane. Chloroethane denotes what? Only one chloro is there. Dichloro denotes what? There are two chloro groups are there. Trichloro denotes what? There are three chloro groups. If one chloro is there, need not to mention mono, because so if you are writing chloro, that denotes one chloro group is there. Okay, so if you are writing 1 comma 2 diol, 1 comma 2 diol means what? Two hydroxy groups are present in the compound. Okay, so in this manner, we have to assign the name for the given compound. Okay, so this is a compound we are taking 1, 2, 3, 4. Four carbon chain is there. So in this four carbon chain, it is possible to start numbering from 1, 2, 3, 4. In this way also, you can count the number. Otherwise, 1, 2, 3, 4. In both the ends, you can start numbering. But which is preferable? Which is preferable? Where the functional group started, there you have to start numbering. Because functional group started from this carbon, right? Here we have OH. That's why here we have to start numbering. This will be given with 1. Here, 2. Here, 3. Here, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So first carbon having hydroxy, second carbon also hydroxy. When hydroxy is there, what is the suffix? Ol is the suffix. How many ols are there? Two ols. That's why diol. Where these two ols are there? First and second. So 1 comma 2 diol. What's the root word? 1, 2, 3, 4. Four carbons. Hence we have to write butane. 1, 2, diol. This will be the IUPAC name of the compound. For that, all these regulations are provided. So, and another requirement over here is punctuations. Punctuations are nothing but where comma is required, where numbers are required, where hyphen is required. In order to mention all this, I'm taking simplest example. Again, here, two carbon chain with the two chloro functional groups. So, where the chloro groups are there, on the first carbon chloro, second carbon also chloro is there. So first carbon 1, second carbon 2. How many chloro groups? 2. That's why di. What are the groups? Chloro. So 1 comma 2. Comma denotes what? Here comma is a punctuation. If comma is not inserted over here, what happens? That will become 12, and that is meaningless. So here punctuation plays a vital role in naming a organic compound. Comma is very essential over here. And hyphen. Why hyphen is required? In order to separate numerals with the alphabets. Hyphen is required over here. So hyphen is also in either punctuation will required in IUPAC nomenclature. And these numerals also parts of, these numbers also parts of punctuations only. Punctuations are maybe comma, numbers and hyphens. All these are required to indicate the name of compound. So when you take this another compound called 1, 2, 3 carbon chain with the chloro group in on the second position, then how can we write the numbering? 1, 2, 3, 3 carbon chain. On the second carbon, chloro is there. That's why you have to indicate 2. And hyphen is required because in order to distinguish numerals with the alphabets, hyphen is required. So 2 hyphen chloro means what? At second place, chloro is there. Then what is the root word? Propane. Propane is the root word. So in this manner, punctuation matters here. If you find more than one substance in the given compound, so for in order to explain this, I'm taking example. So fluoro is there, bromo is there, iodo is there. Then how can we give the numbering for this one? How can we assign numbering? How can we indicate this compound? So in that situation, in order to avoid the ambiguity, you have to go through its alphabetical order. In the alphabetical order, iodo, fluoro, bromo, which will come first? B for bromo, right? So here bromo will come first. A, B, C, D, B will come first. Then A, B, C, D, E, F. So that F, fluoro should be written next. And I will be a last. So here, if more than one functional groups are present, in order to avoid the ambiguity, we have to follow the alphabetical order. Halo groups when taken, you have to assign this alphabetical order. Alkyl groups when present. For example, I have methyl ethyl. Which will come first? Methyl ethyl. Meth means one carbon. Eth means two carbons. Methyl ethyl, how can we give the, which should be come first? According to alphabetical order, in the alphabetical order, E will be the first letter when compared to M. That's the reason why first we have to write ethyl, later on methyl should be written. Here it is clearly mentioned. This is the compound where we are having bromo, iodo, fluoro, but preferably bromo should be written first. This is the first carbon. Second carbon, bromo is there. That's why 2-bromo will be written first according to alphabetical order. Later on, fluoro is there. How many are there? 2. On which carbon? First carbon. So that 1,1-difluoro. 1,1-difluoro. So bromo completed, fluoro completed. And the leftover will be iodo. On what place? Third carbon. So that 3-iodobutane. So 3-iodobutane. So in this manner, we have to assign, if more than one functional group is there, we have to go through alphabetical order of this. And in either is, this is the most important thing to remember. So if more than one functional group is there, one is a carboxylic acid, second is hydroxy. In that case, we have to assign what is the principal functional group in the given compound, and any that is the sub-functional group. Principal functional group is nothing but higher priority group it will be. Highest oxidized one will become higher priority. That is called a principal functional group. Always numbering, wherever it is there, numbering will be started from that only. So if it is there in the left side, numbering will be started from left. If it is there in right side, numbering will be started from right. So that is a higher priority group. So here, carboxylic acid, obviously, in the entire table, this will be highest oxidized one, so that numbering will be started from this. And OH will become side group, side functional group over here. And here, 1, 2, 3, 4 numbering will be started, and this will become, hydroxy will become secondary. So 2-hydroxybutanoic acid, being carboxylic acid is a primary functional group, principal functional group. So what will be the suffix? Oic acid is the suffix. Oic acid means what? Carboxylic acid. Then what will be the root word? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 carbon chain, that's why root word will be buta. So here, this hydroxy will be the side chain. All will not come over here because it is the secondary functional group. That's why it will become 2-hydroxy. It will become 2-hydroxy, and the main word will be oic acid. So in this oic acid, the carbon chain will be 4 carbon, so that it will become butanoic acid. This is the important. For that purpose, we have a sequential order. If compatibility is there among these groups, we have to assign the arrangement. We have to give the priority in this order only. Always acid will come in the first place, later on ester, and the next followed aldehyde, and the next followed ketone, alcohol, and least will be for amine. So if OH and NH2 is there, OH will become primary, NH2 will become secondary. If aldehyde, ketone both are there, aldehyde will become primary, ketone will become secondary. This order is most important in order to assign the name primary and secondary functional groups in the given compound. And these are the various functional groups and their corresponding name of the compound. So how can we assign the naming will be given over here. First is about acid acid halides are given. Acid halides are nothing but C double bond OX will be there. X may be any halogen like a fluoro, chloro, bromo, iodo. You may take any kind of halogen over here. Then name of the system will be suffix always oil halide, oil chloride, oil fluoride, oil bromide. Simply I'm giving examples. CH3C double bond O, C double bond O Cl. In that case, ethanoil chloride is the IUPAC name for that compound. For acid chlorides, oil halide is the suffix. C double bond O X is the functional group present here. Alcohols are designated with OH. OH is called hydroxy functional group. And always IUPAC suffix will be ol. Ethanol, propanol, butanol. In that manner, ol will be the suffix if it is solely present. Aldehyde. Aldehyde functional group represented with CHO. And it is named as formyl. CHO group is called a formyl group. And if aldehyde is there, al is the suffix over here. Al, al will be there. And it is named as a carbaldehyde. This is called a carbaldehyde. Amide. This is the derivative of carboxylic acid. Acid chlorides also derivatives of carboxylic acid, derived from carboxylic acids. When amides are present, C double bond of NH2 group will be there. This is called a carbomyl group. So carbomyl group when present, the naming will be carboxamide. Carboxamide is the name of the compound. For example, if two carbons are there, it will become ethoxamide. In that manner, amides will be named. Carbamyl is the name of the compound. Amines when present, amino. Amine will come in the suffix. Ethanamine, butanamine, propanamine. So in that manner, amines will be named. NH2 is called amine functional group. Carboxylic acid, COOH is the functional group called carboxylic. And oic acid, suffix will be oic acid. Methanoic acid, ethanoic acid, propanoic acid, butanoic acid. In that manner, oic acid is a suffix for carboxylic acid. When ethers are there, alkoxy. Ethers are denoted with alkoxy. When we are taking CH3OCH3, that is called methoxymethane, right? Methoxy is the alkoxy group and methane is the root word methane. One carbon, so that it will be a methane. And ester is there. Again, ester is also a derivative of carboxylic acid. COOR, R, C double bond, OR is called ester. This is designated as oxycarbonyl group. Oxycarbonyl group. So, alkyl alkanoate. Oate is the suffix for this one. Alkyl alkanoate. Ethyl methanoate. Ethyl propanoate. In that manner, esters will be designated. Ketones. C double bond group when present, those are called ketones. Oxo. So it is designated as oxo, but suffix will be one. One means propanone, butanone, pentanone, hexanone. In that manner, one is the suffix. Last word. Last word in the name. Nitriles when present, CN group is called a nitrile. C triple bond N group will be there. It is simply called as cyano. This is a common name. Cyano is a common name. IUPAC name will be nitrile. So the naming will be in such a manner. Nitrile will be a suffix over here. Ethane nitrile, propane nitrile, methane nitrile. So in that manner, naming this carbon also counted for the root word. So only the difference is this carbon is also counted for the root word. For example, if you are having CH3CN, so it will become two carbon chain rather than one carbon chain. So you have to indicate as a ethane nitrile, but not methane nitrile for this cyanofunctional group. This is about the tabular form representation in accordance with the IUPAC, where functional group and its representation, what is the IUPAC name for these functional groups are provided in this tabular form. By this, we completed the introduction to the nomenclature. In the next session, we will go with a few examples pertaining to organic compounds, how the naming will be given based on these protocols in accordance with the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. In the session, we discussed about how can we bisect the molecule, name of the molecule, into prefix. A middle one is called a root word, suffix. Prefix is nothing but starting one. A root word is nothing but middle one. Suffix is nothing but last one. In order to assign naming for different compounds, here different rules are provided for prefix, middle word, and also suffix. All these were extensively studied in the session. Hope this will be helpful for your preparation. Thank you very much for your consistent listening. Thank you, one and all.